इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल?
नो
नो
मैम,
मैम।
नो मैम।
ओके नाउ।
यस मैम, यस मैम, यस मैम।
ओके सो इन द लास्ट क्लास अपार्ट फ्रॉम विद सम थ्योरी कॉन्सेप्ट्स वी हैव आल्सो स्टार्टेड विद द प्रोग्रामिंग एज वेल द बेसिक सिंटैक्स दैट यू नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इन ऑर्डर टू राइट अ सिंपल प्रोग्राम इन द जावा। Okay, so since Java is completely object-oriented programming language, you always need to start writing your program using the classes over here. So the classes and the objects are the two concepts that is going to make the Java as a object-oriented programming, and which is the backbone of the Java programming language here. Okay, so to begin to write with the any program, so you need to start with the keyword class. See, probably it would be more helpful if you take this class as with the public access specifier if it contains the main function within it. Okay, so even though if here there is no public access specifier for this class, you can take the public keyword before this, and the mandatory keyword that you need to use here is class, followed by the space and followed by the name of the class. Okay, so you can take the if anyone has switched on your microphone, please switch it off to avoid the disturbance here. I'm getting some noise over here, please. Okay, so when I ask you to switch on and speak, you can switch on the microphone at that time, but right now you please switch it off. Okay, so followed by the name of the class. So the whatever the class name that you are going to take over here, that has to be the name of the file as well, as I told you in the last class. Okay, so to begin with writing the body of this class, take the flower opening flower brace here. So these are the comment lines. There are the three types of the comment lines, in fact. So the first one is here, which has been started with the forward slash followed by the star, and take the as many lines as you want as a comment line. I hope you know what is the comment line, right? So followed by, once you write all the lines, end it with a star and the forward slash. So this is said to be as a multi-line comment line. Okay, so when you have the more number of the lines to be included as a comment lines, do include it with this pattern. Okay, suppose if you have only the single line as a comment line, you can write it with the two forward slashes here. Okay, so class, name of the class followed by the flower bracket, and then one class in your entire Java program should contain the main function, for which it should have the access specifier as a public. The main function should be always access specifier as a public, because this is where the execution of the Java program is to begin. Okay, so public followed by the static, followed by the void, all separated with the space and followed by the main. So this is where the execution of the program is going to begin. And even though if you do not have the any parameters to pass in order to execute this program, the default one should be the string followed by the arguments. The string followed by the arguments as a parameter, followed by the array of the arguments. So don't worry, you'll get to know about meaning of this once we get deep into this subject. Okay, so the those who have attended the earlier classes, you know that for what purpose the public is used and what are the other two access specifiers. What are the other two access specifiers?
Private and protected.
Very good. Private and the protected. So as I told you, these are to provide the encapsulation concept where you need can provide the security to the sum of the methods and the data within your program. But since it is a main function which has to be executed in order to begin with the running of the program, it should be always with the public. Do remember this. Why I'm repeating is, whenever you are writing the main function, the express specifier for the main function should be always public only, and it has to be static and void. So when it has to be void, when it doesn't have anything to return as a result at the time, it should have the void here, right? So followed by the parameters as a string and the square brackets as a to make it as a array of the arguments. Then it has to again take the another flower bracket to begin with the body of this main function here. So here it is a simple Java program where we are interested only to display a simple statement here. This is a simple Java program, right? So how to do that? System.out.println. println. Right, so do concentrate here. S is a capital case letter. It has to be capital only. Why? Because these are the keywords and Java is a case sensitive programming language. Okay, so all the keywords needs to be the same as it has been provided by the Java programming language, right? So system.out.println, this is a simple Java program. So what does this is going to do is this particular function, it is going to display this message on the screen. So this is what we have discussed in the last class, and this is how you need to start. So those who are attending for directly for the today's class, do remember that the Java programming has to start with creating the class which contains the main function. So it doesn't matter whether you take this class at the first or the beginning of the program or in the mid. So no, wherever you want, you can take it. But the execution of the Java program is always going to begin with this main function only. And your Java program may contain the n number of the classes. It's not restricted to only one class. It may contain the n number of the classes, but there should be only one class which contains the main function, and we should have the public access specifier and where does the execution of the program is going to begin. Is this, are these things clear to you people? And even I have shown in the last class the execution of this.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Especially I'm asking those who are attending the for the first class. Those who said that you are attending for the first today's class. So is the, are these things clear to you?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay. So this is the another program where we have the some more statements within it, the same one here, which is more clear here. Okay. So I'm not going to once again explain you the every line of the program over here. These are the comment lines, which is that here is another short example. And you can call this file as a example2.java. So can anyone tell me why it has to be named as a example2.java? The name of the this file has to be saved as a example2.java. Why is that so?
Class name.
Class name. Which class name? Which class name?
File.
Which class? So here, this is a very simple program where it has a only one class. Suppose if we have the 3-4 classes with the different names, then
class name.
Which class name do you consider
main.
For yeah
class with main function?
Yeah, do remember this. Do remember this. Not only the class name which contains the main function. Do remember this. Okay, suppose if your file contains the 3 to 4 classes or the more, you cannot take the any class of your choice. The you have to take the class name which contains the main function here. So in this case, though you have the only one class, it has the main function. Suppose if you have the two classes, consider the class which has the main function. Okay, so here you can see, and there are a few more statements as compared to the first example, what we have just now discussed, right? So as the name indicates, public. So as I told you, the main function should have the access specifier as a public static void main followed by the same arguments, right? So here you have the two statements. You can see a int num and num is equal to 100. So what these two statements are, which are exactly same as what you did in the C programming language. If you does remember something, so can anyone yes, tell me what these
variable two are? And assigning the value to variable, ma'am.
Yes. The first statement is the variable declaration. It is said to be as a declaration of variable. Say there is a certain terminology that you need to understand that how you need to define a variable. So for example, I'll just show you here what is the terminology. Always the variable declaration should start with a data type. Data type followed by the space and followed by the variable name, right? So this is the syntax that you need to follow, right? So data type followed by the variable name and followed by the semicolon, right? So if you do not follow this syntax, probably you will get an error. Okay, So data type can be of the any type whichever you require. In this example, since the integer data type is required, integer in the sense the numbers. So I'll be explaining you in the very basic manner. Why? Because a few people might remember the programming concept and few may not remember it, right? So I will be considering the one who might not remember by considering, by keeping them in mind, I might be explaining. So just those who are very much familiar with the programming concept, you can just ignore it if you know it already. Okay. So the data declaration should always start with the data type followed by the space and variable name of your choice, right? So variable name can begin with the letters and it can begin with the underscore followed by the letters. So apart from these two terms, you should not have the anything. For example, data type of anything, it may be int, it may be float of any data type, right? So all should be in the lowercase letters, right? So here it is taking the by default as a F as a capital letter, so just ignore it. All should be in the lowercase letters followed by the space, and as I told you, it can start with the underscore even, or else you can start with the any letter followed by the underscore with the anything, right? So this is also the one example, and you can also take it as a underscore followed by the ABC, right? So these two terminologies are allowed, and you cannot have the variable name beginning with the number or the any decimal number, right? So you, however, you can have the preceding value as a number. For example, you can have the variable name as a A1, but you cannot have the variable name as a 1A. So do remember these terminologies to understand that the what are the valid data variable names that you can take for the declaration. Okay, so in this example, they have taken here it as a the name of the variable as a num. So can anyone tell me what is meant by variable actually?
Which stores the value, ma'am, or data?
It is a memory location in the computer. So where it is going to temporarily allocate a memory to give and to store some value in it, right? So this memory is not a permanent. So it is going to be used only during the execution of this program. So the memory will not be permanently stored. So once you compile this, once you run this program, only at that period of time, the memory will be allocated and it will be stored with a name as a num, and it will be stored with the value, whatever the value is assigned for it. Okay. So here in this case, in this example, a num has been created as a variable with an integer data type. That means you can store only the integer values into this variable num, right? So follow to that, you can see here num is equal to 100. So this is the way how you can assign the values here. So the syntax for assigning the values to the any variable should be in the same pattern. Variable name followed by the equal to symbol and followed by the integer value if it is an integer data type to store in it, and followed by the semicolon here, right? So declaration has been done, assignment of value has been done. And next thing is, if you wish to print it, so this is the way how you can print the values. So in the earlier example, you have seen the printing only the text information on the screen. But now we will see how to print the value stored into any variable here, right? So the for printing anything on the screen, the function is going to remain same. That is system.out.println. And into the round braces, within the double quotation, whatever you are going to take within the double quotation, the same thing is going to be reflected on the screen, right? So this is sum followed by the colon and followed by the space. Everything is going to be considered as the same when it wants to display it on the screen. And you can see after the double quotation, you have something over here, right? So plus num. So which is somewhat different to what you have studied in the C programming language whenever you want to take the value to be printed from the sum variable. I think there you have taken it there as a percentage D in order to fill the value, followed by the comma and followed by just only the name of the variable. But whereas here in this Java, you can see here it is somewhat different. Here you are not going to take the any format specifier. The percentage D, what you have used, percentage D, F, C, or S, whatever you have used in the C, those are termed as a format specifiers. But here you do not require to use it in the Java. Right. So simply you can take only the statement to be displayed on the screen, and whatever you want to be followed, the value stored in the variable, you can just truncate it with a plus symbol followed by the name of the variable. So here this plus num means it is going to take the value that has been stored from the variable num, that is 100. Okay. So followed to that, you can see here something else also has been done here. Suppose if you want to do any mathematical operation, you can always do it. So what has been done here? The variable num has been taken equal to, and the value what has been stored in the num, it has to be multiplied with the 2, and the result of this operation again has to be stored in the num. That means whatever the value earlier that has been stored in this num has to be replaced with this result. It is not going to create the new variable here. Instead, the value that has been stored, that is 100, it will be overridden or replaced with the whatever the result that is going to be this by this operation, that is 100 into 2, 2, 200 will be stored or replaced in the num by deleting the 100 over there. Right. So follow to that, you can see here even some printing also has been done. So every time, I'm not going to repeat that this function is used for the printing. You can see here a system.out.print has been taken here. Right. So println is also allowed, and even only the print is also allowed. The both the functions can be used for printing purpose. So you can see here the value of num into 2 is. So both has been taken, everything has been taken in the double quotation. That means this entire statement is going to be displayed as it is on the screen. Right. So followed by what you want to print, you want to just print the value stored in the num. Here you can see system.out.println, only the name of the variable has been taken without taking the plus symbol here. So can you just tell me what is the difference between these two statements? Here you have taken the plus symbol, but here no plus symbol has been taken. Why? Because here you need not want to concat it with the any string value. Instead, you are just taking only the value stored in the variable. Here there are the two parts. The first part of the print statement is a string. I hope you know what is a string. Anything you take into the single quote and or the double quotations, that is considered as a string. Suppose if you are taking both the string as well as the variable value to be filled into the same print statement, at that time make sure that after or before the string statements, it has to concatenate it with the plus symbol with the variable name over here. So here, since you are using two separate functions for printing the values, one for only the string, another one for the value stored in the variable, at that time, at the second statement, if you have only the value to be considered from the variable stored without considering the string, you can directly take only the name of the variable here. Okay, so here it is going to take it as the value of the num into 2 is, this will be printed first and then the 200. So is everyone clear with the every single statement from this example here?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. And just try to execute this.
Ma'am?
Yes.
Ma'am, can we add last statement into the second last statement only, ma'am? Yes. The value of num.
Yes,
into 2 is.
Yes, you can add it by using the plus symbol here.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. I'll just try to show it. Yes. Yeah, I'll just show it in the execution only. That will be more clear for you. Okay. Is this window visible to you?
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes.
Okay. You can see here for this, even though in your example you don't have the public access specifier for class over there, because some of the editors will not allow you to execute if the main function class, if it even if it also doesn't have the public access specifier. Okay. So if I run this program, you can see here by default the name of the file has been considered as a example2.java, so which is exactly same as the name of the class which contains the main function here. So the output of this is, this is num 100 which has been stored here, and followed by the value of the num into 2 is 100. So since we have not taken any new line character here, both the display is going to be concatenated one after the other. Right. So some of you have the confusion of the plus symbol, right? So what I'll do now, right? So you can see here, these are the two ways that has that you can take for printing anything if you have the variable value to be filled on the screen there, right? So here the num of the value of the num into 2 is, so you can see here the entire this part is a string which is a in the double quotation, so that means this part will be taken exactly as it is to be printed, the value of the num into 2, right? So the another way is, if you do not want to use this concatenation operator, this plus is said to be the concatenation operator, you can go for using the another print function, right? So only by directly taking the name of the variable which you want to print. So if you want to just skip and you want to take this thing into the here itself, so what you need to do is, I'll just show you here only use the plus symbol and take it as a name of the variable where you want to fill that value, right? So I'll re-execute this program. The output remains same here. Got an idea? Both are same. You can use the either of these two ways. So why it has been taken is to tell you or to show you that the both the ways of displaying are correct in Java. You can go for either using the only single print statement by using the concatenation operator if you have the variable as well as the string to be displayed, or else you can use it separately by using the two print statements. Now, is it clear to every one of you?
Yes.
Okay. Is there any doubt in any of this statement here? Because clarifying the doubts in the beginning of the classes is going to be very helpful for you to understand later. So do not try to keep the even minute of the doubts within you, because that minute doubts may lead to the confusion as we proceed with the further syllabus. Okay. So is there any doubt to any one of you with this example?
No, ma'am.
Okay. So coming to the next concept, the two control statements. Right. So all of you are again, see, all the things what we are discussing in the first two modules is going to be same, exactly the same what you have studied in the other programming language. What you, the logic behind the each concept is going to remain same, whereas it is only going to differ slightly in the syntax. That's it. Okay. So don't be confused that what you are studying is exactly going to be same. Of course, whichever the programming language that you take, the concepts are going to remain same for the first few things, right? So for that, you need to concentrate only on the syntax if it is going to be different from the other programming language. Okay. So what is meant by the control statement?
We can control the flow of the execution of program.
In the sense, others, I want everyone also to be interactive. Right? Do not just listen to the class and keep quiet. If you are interactive in the class, then only the class is going to be interesting, and you people also are able to remember the things. Not only understanding, you will be able to remember it, right? So what is meant by the control statements? how will be the flow of the execution if you use the control statements, and what will be the result if you use the any control statements in your program? Do you remember?
Yes, ma'am. We will have some condition, ma'am. If that condition is true, then the statement which is belong to that block, that will be executed, ma'am. Mm-hmm. And if that condition is false, then the controller will go to next step.
Very good. So this is very simple, right? So the two control statements are if statement and if else, right? So which one you have to use in your program, there is no standard restriction, right? So depending upon the for which you are writing the program and what kind of result you are expecting, you can decide if you want to use only the if statement or else you need to use both the if and the if else statements. Okay, but the syntax, basic syntax for using the if statement is the keyword is if followed by the condition within the braces and follow the statement which you want to execute for that if statement, right? So the statement has to end with the semicolon. It should be the mandatory, right? So this is the syntax that you need to follow. If you want to note down it, you can note down it. However, everything is there in your textbook, right? So I cannot monitor that whether you are writing or note down the things unless it is a offline class, isn't it? So my suggestion to you is quickly, it would be better if you pen down something whenever is discussed so that the things will be more easy for you people only. Okay, so if followed by the condition. See, how does this if is going to work is depending upon this condition, right? So if the condition is this condition, whatever you are going to take, it is going to give the result in the form of a binary, right? I hope you know what is the binary, right? Zero or one. One and the same. True or false. Whatever just now she told, true or false or the zero or one. If you consider it in a computer language, this condition will give the result as a in the form of a binary operator, either 0 or 1. If it is 0, this statement will not be executed. And if it is a 1, this particular statement will be executed. Right. So one example you can see here. If num is less than 100, the statement that has to be executed for this condition is system.out.println, the number is less than 100. So how does this is going to execute here? So it will check whatever the value that you have stored in this variable, it will first check whether it is less than 100. So if it is less than 100, it is going to give the if result, the result of this if statement is 1. If it is 1, this statement will be executed. If it is not less than 1, it will give the result as a 0, then this statement will not be executed over there. Right? So it is a very simple example that has been demonstrated here. Right? Likewise, so what are the different operators that you can use as a condition over here? You can see here, these are the different operators. Not only less than, you can use the less than, greater than, equal to, even you can also use the not equal to, even you can also use the greater than or equal to, or less than or equal to. So these all are the operators that you can use in the if statement here. So follow to that, you have this example to demonstrate exactly how does the if statements works here, right? So here for simplicity in this entire chapter, we have considered only one class. In the main function itself, we have defined all the operations to be carried out to demonstrate the if conditions here, right? So you can see here class if sample. As I told you, the name of the class can be anything, but the class which contains the main function should be the name of the file here. So you can see here, if sample.java has been taken as the name of the file here. Right. So public, static, void, main. So everything remains same. And this statement is for the variable declaration where it has taken the integer data type, that is int x comma y. Two variables has been taken of the integer type, and followed to that, some values has been assigned to these variables here. X is equal to 10 and y is equal to 20. Right. So let's see what has been done in the further statement here. Is everyone listening, right? My voice is audible.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. You are able to follow my language, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So follow to that, you can see here if x is less than y. So it is very simple example just to show you that how you can use the if statements, right? So if x is less than y, what it has to do here? It has to execute. If this condition satisfied, that is, if the result of this condition is true, it has to execute this statement, system.out.println, where it has to display x is less than y. Right. So follow to that, there is a some operation. X is equal to x into 2. That means the value of x has been modified here. That means which becomes 20 here. And to check out, and then follow to this statement, again we have used the one more if condition, if x is equal to y. Of course, after performing this operation, the value of the x has been changed. That is, it has been changed from the 10 to 20. And if you check the after this, whether the value of the x and y are same, if this is true, then it is going to display the result as x is now equal to y. Right. Then after that, you can see here again, x has been multiplied again by 2, now which it becomes 40. Right. So again, another if statement has been used to check out whether the x is greater than y. If it is true, again, it is going to display the message as x is now greater than y. Right. And lastly, you can see here if it, again, the another if statement has been used to check out whether x is equal to y. So can anyone tell me whether this statement will be able to display the result, whether this condition is satisfied?
No, ma'am.
No. Because no. after this operation, what is the value of the x variable?
40.
40. And what will be the value of the y variable?
20.
20. Y variable is not going to change anything. Why? Because we have not at all done any operations on the y variable. That's why the y variable, whatever has been stored initially, that will remain same. Right. So in the rest of the cases, the x value has been modified after each operation, and only the variable y x variable has been changed over there. So let's see again the execution of this statement. Hope everyone have the book with you, at least the soft copy.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so you can see based upon the same explanation, whatever I explained, initially it will check whether x is less than y. Of course, x is less than y, 10 is less than 20. So if this part will be executed, x is less than y will be displayed. And then what we have done, x is equal to x into 2 has been taken here. So that means x now becomes as a 20. And 20 is equal to 20. So that's why it displays x now equal to y. This statement, x now equal to y. So follow to that, again, x has been multiplied by 2. Now the x becomes 40. And of course, the 40 is greater than 20. Now, and that's why it displays x now greater than y. Right. So at last, again, it will execute. So this part will also be executed to check whether now the x is equal to y, which is not true. Why? Because after this statement, the x value is 40. If you want, you can check out here. So directly, I will display only the x value. So to check out what is the x value. Okay, so I have not put the semicolon here. So this, see, you can observe here, you will get an error if you miss the any syntactical part. Okay, so you can see here the x value is now 40. Right, so after this operation, the x value is 40. And at this statement, if you check whether the x is equal to y, which is not true, 40 is not equal to 20. So for this particular statement will not be executed. Right. So is everyone clear with this example as well? Or else do you have any doubt?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you want me to explain anything else, or someone is having any doubt? So what you need to, though you know the meaning of the if statement, how it will be executed, you should be familiar with the syntax that is used here in the programming language. Okay. Any doubts so far what we have discussed?
Is there any indentation?
No. Actually, in this online editor, there is no indentation rule over here. But once I use the editor, the Java kit over there, once I install in my system, I'll check it over there. Probably there will be no indentation. Why? Because here there is a single statement. Suppose if you have the multiple statements, that is the block of the statements, which I am going to discuss in the next concept itself, there you are using the flower brackets to include the block of the statements. That means your indentation is not at all required. If you do not use the flower brackets, at that time you should have the indentation, which is done in the Python programming language. Okay. So here probably, according to me, 90% there is no indentation. So let me check out even that also. Right.
Yes, ma'am.
Anything else? Today itself, I'll try to share a video, or else I'll make the video by myself that how you can install the Java. Even I have not yet installed the Java in my system. Okay, that's why I'm using the online editor. Okay, so if time permits for me, I'll try to share that video as well. So if you have the laptop, you can install it in your system and you can practice your programs there itself. Okay.
Okay.
So further things will continue in the next class. Does anyone want to ask anything else?
No, ma'am.
Okay. Then we'll have the discussion in tomorrow's class.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.